Hi, I'm Tom, and today we're going to meet the brass band. Welcome to the Bandroom. You can probably already hear the players from the brass band warming up behind me by buzzing on their mouthpieces. This is the way we produce the sound. The vibration on the mouthpiece is amplified through the instrument, and the valves or slides help us to play different notes. A proper warm-up is very important for musicians because it helps us to play our best. Now, let's start with the engine room of the brass band. The bass section. These are the biggest instruments in the band, which also means they're the lowest in pitch. The E-flat basses are just like the tuba of the orchestra, but the monstrous B-flat basses are even bigger again. The basses are usually in charge of playing the lowest notes and help to give us the wonderful, dark, rich sound of the brass band. The euphonium looks similar in appearance to our basses, but is smaller in size. This means they are very versatile instruments, able to play low enough to support the bass section, but also often used as soloists, or to play fast, challenging music. Like the symphony orchestra, the brass band also has a trombone section. These forward-facing instruments can sound forceful, majestic, or even jazzy. The oldest instruments in the band, trombones have a slide to help them change notes, rather than valves like other brass instruments. This allows them to bend pitches up or down easily as they play. This technique is called a glissando. The bass trombone is bigger than the two tenor trombones in the band. This means that it specialises in playing low notes. Not to be confused with the horns of the orchestra, tenor horns and baritones are unique instruments to the brass band. Together with the euphoniums, they are modern versions of the sax horn family, and they are a key ingredient in the distinctive sound of the brass band, giving a sonorous warmth to the middle of the ensemble. They often play an accompanying role, but are just as nimble to take the lead too. The flugelhorn is a very special instrument. Looking across between a cornet and a horn, the brass band has only one flugel and it has several roles to play. As well as being a soloist, the specific characteristics of the flugelhorn allow it to link and blend the warm sound of the tenor horns into the higher voices of the cornets, right up to the highest brass voice in the band, the tiny soprano cornet. The cornets are the smallest instruments in the brass band, and they outnumber every other section. Much like their orchestral trumpet counterparts, they face forward when playing and can sound brash and forceful, yet also sweet and delicate in the right hands. Their small size also means they can play with agility and precision, as a solo or as a whole cornet section. Thank you. percussion section of the brass band is very important. Drums and unpitched percussion help to drive the beat and rhythm along, adding emphasis and precision to the music. Tuned instruments like the vibraphone, glockenspiel, xylophone and marimba can add a sparkle of brightness to the brass band sound, or create a completely different atmosphere altogether. Using mutes for the brass instruments also changes the sound they make. This allows composers to manipulate or disguise the timbre of instruments to create different colours and moods within the music. Well, now we're all introduced, let's try bringing everyone together. Starting with the basses and percussion to give us the foundation of the music, we'll add on each section of the band in layers, from the euphoniums, trombones, baritones and horns, right up to the cornets. Our piece of music is based on a very famous theme. Have you spotted it yet? Listen carefully and see if you can hear it in our finale. As we bid you farewell, sit back and enjoy the wonderful sound of the brass band. And who knows, next time you may even get the opportunity to join in. Welcome to the band room. We'll be right back.